Hello, guys. Hello, hello, hello. I am just coming on. I'm super excited about this, guys. I'm actually inviting a few people who said they want to come. Who were very interested about this video. Let's do it. Okay. Okay, guys, when you're on, say hello. I don't usually go live on this like phone, so I'm not really sure. I won't know you're here unless you say hello, but we're gonna have some fun today. I'm so excited. So if you're there, say hello. Let me see if I can see my comments over here because I can't really see comments. Oh, yay! Hey, Jenny! Yay, Jenny's here! I'm so excited. Oh my gosh. I hope you guys are having a good Friday. Hey, I hope you guys are having a really good Friday. I'm having an amazing Friday. I'm feeling really fiery today. So I'm just like kind of talking and letting people come on and get here. But I will say this is grown woman conversation that we're gonna have here on this live today. We're gonna have a really good time. It's Friday. I'm gonna get you guys all fired up. I'm gonna get you guys super excited. And I'm gonna give a lot away. This is not like one of those lives where I'm just gonna dance around what you guys should be doing and what you could be doing and how you can do this and then secretly tell you, oh yeah, but wait, you're gonna need this to figure it out. No, I'm gonna make sure that you leave here with your mind fucking blown. How does that sound? I'm gonna make sure that you leave here like a whole new woman because that's what I'm here for. I'm so excited you're here, Tanya. I'm so excited. Whoever's here, say hi, tell me you're here. If you're watching live, let me know. Don't be a creeper, say hello so we can talk. And then if you are catching the replay, go ahead and type replay so I know you are here so I can come back and give you some love and talk to you and have fun with you too. So, I'm so excited, guys. I literally have been having download after download the last couple days. So I'm exhausted because I stayed up late and then I woke up in this like fiery type of energy and I'm so here for it. I'm so here for it. It's going to be so much freaking fun. And you guys are going to have the best weekend because we're having this conversation. I said this has to be had now because then you guys can go have your fun this weekend. And I'm so happy you are here. I'm so freaking excited. Oh my God. Okay. So if you have kids around, this is not for your kids. It's not for your kids, so put some headphones in. So put some headphones in so we can talk freely. This is for you. If you're around your man, make sure you have headphones in because I don't need them knowing our secrets. This is for the ladies. So we're gonna talk about all of this. Okay, so let's talk about it because I've been getting lots of questions about manifestation, all the things, how to attract money, all the different ways, how to attract what I want, how do I attract what I want for somebody else, and oh my God, Jenny, yes. So I wanna just talk to you guys a little bit and share a little bit, and let me give you some backstory. If you're new to me, if you haven't seen me before, if you haven't watched me on video, I know I haven't gone live that much in this group, but that'll change. I just go when I'm excited because I do what I'm feeling led to do, but I'm feeling called to do this a lot more and I'm getting more questions. So as you give me questions, I feel the need to come on and talk to you more, which is a great like energy exchange here. So I love to manifest. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. It's energy and it's flowing and it's feeling and it's giving and it's happening and it's doing things and I'm getting things and it's feeling so powerful and I can create what I want and I can lead with my desires and I can get it and it's good and it's feeling great, right? That's what I love. Let me tell you, if you are, hey, Courtney, so happy you're here. If you are a business owner, it doesn't fucking have to be this difficult. It really doesn't. It's your idea that it does, that it is. So I am here to have fun. I'm not here to give you a whole bunch of actionable fucking steps that you write down, and it's going to be boring and not my vibe. So we're going to have fun today, and we're going to have so much fun that you're going to be so excited that you're going to go like live this freaking weekend, and you're going to tell me all about it because we're best friends. We're going to be best friends after this because we can't share. I can't talk to you like I'm going to talk to you and then we not be friends. So it's like girlfriends having a slumber party, and we're going to be the best of friends after this because it's going to get so super personal, and it's going to like give you all the things, and I'm so here for it. So yes, have you, and Jenny listened to my manifestation audio. And for those of you who haven't gotten that from me, I am actually putting it in like a video type of format. It's old as last year, and this is going to be the new and improved. And I'm just going to keep building and keep adding because there's so much I can do to go into this. That audio, I'm going to just put it to like an image so you can listen. It's not going to have my face, but you'll be able to still hear all the things because that one is so good. It's just, it's powerful, but this one is gonna blow your freaking mind. If you like that, if you've heard that audio, you're gonna just like die over this. And let me just turn off my notifications because I'm here with you. I wanna be here with you. I wanna be present with you. I don't need any kind of interruptions whatsoever. So let's talk about it. Everything you do is energy. Everything you do is energy. Manifestation is feminine. It's with your feminine energy. And I know people talk about feminine and masculine energy to the point where you probably think you know all the things. You probably think, oh yeah, I know what feminine energy is. If you've been hearing about it, I know what masculine energy is. I got this, I know this, I'm doing this. And this is not new to me. Let me just tell you, I'm about to blow your mind here. You don't know all the things. There are so many things that we do that are feminine, that we feel are feminine, that are masculine in our lives. And the reason why, I know you guys are probably like, I thought this was manifestation. I thought she was going to talk all the things money. I thought she was going to talk to me about like how I can get, how can I receive. Okay. Well, yeah, I'm getting to it. This all has to do with your energy. Your energy is everything. You are always manifesting. Always, always. You're always manifesting. The issue is most of us are not manifesting what we want. We're manifesting what we don't want. We're manifesting more wanting, more needing, more hoping. And we're not manifesting what we truly desire because we don't know how, because we're so stuck in the doing, in the how. That's masculine. That's masculine. Masculine is the need to know how. Masculine is the strategy. Masculine is the need to fix things. That's masculine. From masculine energy, it's very difficult to have a feminine result, which is manifestation. So it is up to us to cultivate our feminine energy and to step in that power, in our feminine power, because feminine, there's a misconception that being in our feminine means being weak. Feminine energy is it's the strongest energy on the planet. It is the strongest energy on the planet. And when you tap into that power, in that inner power, that inner truth, that inner softness, that women are magnetic. Feminine energy is magnetic. It's fire. It's that energy. It's that like, I'm going to learn something good, right? Like it's that energy that you're giving off that you're like, you're giving off all the vibes. You're giving off all the vibes. People can't wait to be around you. People are like, oh my God, it's just something about her. You people see you on the street and they're like, oh my God, there's just something about you. I can't explain it. It's your energy. Have you ever had somebody tell you it's your energy? It's your energy. I just want to be in your energy. Like you have a contagious energy. You have that energy that makes me just like want to be around you. If you haven't experienced that, we're going to blow your mind. We're going to fix all that because you need to experience that. Yes. Yes. Oh my gosh. Then Courtney, if that's what you're here for, you just wait. I hope you bought popcorn. I hope you bought wine. Just be ready because this is going to be like fire. I'm so excited. So that feminine energy, that's when you're magical. That's when the things are happening, the things are coming to you. You're getting free shit. You're getting free coffees. You're getting, can I upgrade you? Can I do this? Can I do that? People want to give to you because you're in that feminine energy. Because in your feminine energy, you're receiving. When you're feminine energy, you're able to receive because receiving is feminine. Receiving is feminine. So if you do have paper, if you want to write notes, you can write notes, but I really want you to be present and to listen. I honestly think that I'm going to save this in the group. This is going to be here. You can go back and write notes because this is going to have lots of little gems and little magic. And if you want to write it in the comments so you can go back and see the comments and write it down, that's great. But feminine energy, it's magnetic. It's that energy that, oh my gosh, I just need to be around her. I don't need to know why. I just need her. I just want her. I can't understand it. I just want to be in her presence. I just need to be there. I just want to be around her. I just want to be next to her. I just want to do that. That's feminine. That's feminine energy. Okay. When you're in your masculine, that's when you're feeling like, I need to fix this. I need to fix this. I need to do this. How do I do this? When you are constantly asking, how do I fix this? How do I fix this? How can I make this work? How can I do this? How can I do that? How can I, that you're in your freaking masculine. Let me tell you, you can have what you want either way. You can have what you want from the masculine. You can have what you want from the feminine, but being in your feminine means you are feeling, you are experiencing. So I ask you this on this video, how do you want to feel in your life? How do you want to feel in your business? How do you want to feel in your attraction process? How do you want to feel when you're manifesting? What do you want that experience to be like for you? Do you want it to be fun? Do you want it to be exciting? Do you want to not be able to wait? And I can't wait to do it. I just want to do it. You're getting all like excited. You could feel it building in your system, in your nervous system, and you're like getting chills, and you cannot wait. You cannot wait. It feels so good. It feels amazing. It feels, it's that feeling. Did you see that? That's the feeling. If you don't have that feeling, you're likely in your masculine. And it's so easy to get put in our masculine because doing the bills is masculine, cleaning the house is masculine, although we feel it's feminine, right? In the movies, like the girl cleaning the house is feminine. No, it's masculine. It's in the doing. So we're constantly using that masculine throughout the day. We're constantly using that masculine all the time. If we're business owners, we're creating the things, we're doing the things, so we're in our masculine. So the challenge then becomes, well, how can I be in my feminine more? How can I deep into that womanly presence? Being feminine is all about pleasure. It's all about desire. It's all about feeling. And once you get into that, it's easier to create the life that you want. So let's talk about it, right? And let's talk about like the idea of sex and the idea of relationships and how your relationships and dating and the dynamics and all of the things, because it all ties into your feminine and masculine energies and how you're able to attract and manifest in your life. Okay, because how you show up in one area of your life is how you show up in all areas. And instead of me giving you a bulletproof list that tells you to write down what you want 555 times on a million sheets of paper and repeat it and repeat it and repeat it and affirm yourself and do all these things. I could tell you that. Does that work? It could. It could. If you're in your feminine, it could work. Or I can tell you the real deal. I can tell you how it can feel easy. I can quiet the noise around you and show you how easily this relates to something in our lives, that this can become powerful, and how your energy, the energy you're giving off in one area, the energy that you've forgotten, because most of us know this, most of us learn this at a younger age, but we forget it. And we think one doesn't have anything to do with the other. We think our relationships and sex and all the things don't have anything to do with our manifestations. They don't have anything to do with our ability to create and attract money whenever we so-called please. And we feel there's so much we need to do. And you can manifest for yourself. You can manifest for other people. You don't have to just manifest for yourself. But it's when you're in that energy, things just come and you can spread that around to people who are around you. And it just becomes this beautiful, beautiful art of receiving, this dance, this choreographed piece. And that is what we want. That is when we're in our power. That is when we're in our truth. And that is when the magic truly happens. This is where the magic truly happens. And I told a client today, I said, you know, I'm really good with the masculine. I'm really good with strategy. I'm really good with all these things. And I can give you that, but I really feel it's doing people a disservice. I feel it does you a disservice, because here's the thing, masculine almost always feels stressful and hard. It does not feel good. And I say, I want women who want things to feel amazing. I want you to feel amazing in your life. I want you to learn that you don't have to experience pain, and you don't have to experience resistance, and you don't have to have the heart to experience the joy, the ease, and the freedom of abundance. Hey, Paula, I'm so glad that you're here. So this is my goal, and I really want things to be that simplistic for you. So here's what I want you to see. When you are in a relationship, when you are first getting involved with somebody, when you have those feelings, if you can recall back to your marriage, if you could call back to the people that you date, when you go back and you realize, how did I feel? How do I feel? Do you remember, hey, Christina, when it was so exciting, when it felt so good, and when you're like, yes. Ooh, I'm so excited. They're so amazing. They make me feel so good. And I just can't wait to be around them. And I'm just like, I'm feeling all the things. I'm doing all the things. And I'm going to get to where this connects to how we manifest and how we bring in money. But just stay with me for a while. This is going to be fun. So you're in those vibes. You're in those feelings. And you're just like, oh my God, this feels so good. And you're doing all these things. And you're excited to see them. And you're like, I'm so excited. I miss you. I just can't wait. I just can't get enough, right? And you're feeling, you don't have to force that, do you? No, you don't force that. It just is. It's just exciting. It's just magical. And they're really not doing all these things. They could just be like, oh yeah. Oh, you're so nice. Oh, you're so pretty. And you're just like, oh my God, I'm so pretty. I'm so pretty. I'm so pretty. I'm so amazing. Oh my God. Oh my God. He thinks like he sees me. He loves me. Oh my God. This is amazing. This is great. And really, he just told you what you already know, because we're all beautiful, right? Like we know we're beautiful. I mean, we do the hair, we do the things. When you first meet somebody, you're in your zone. Oh yeah. Yeah, I know. Me and Christina talked about this last night, and ever since, she's been like raking it in. She's been like raking that shit in, like clients out the ass, like over here to you, over here to you. Come to me, come to me, come to me, come to me. And it's working, and it's working, and it's working, because it's magic. This is magic. So you're loving it, and you're feeling it, and you're feeling so attracted, and you're feeling that desire, although we want to not admit that we desire them so much, and we yearn for them, and we need, like, we want it so bad. Have you ever wanted someone so bad because you're so excited to be around them, and that good feeling that they're giving you? Yes. That feeling's everything. So we want it all the time, and we're like doing all the things for it. We're trying to make it pleasurable, and that's the thing. When you're trying to like date and you're romancing, or even with your husband, like that gives him a different energy, and he can't get enough and you can't get enough, because he feels honored, he feels excited, he feels appreciated, he feels desired. Not needed, but desired. There's a difference. Needed doesn't feel very good. Needed feels like when you say to somebody, I need you to do this, how does that feel? Does that feel like you want to do that? Or do you go, you need me to do that? Like, really? What now? That's what I feel anyway. Like, it doesn't feel good. But when somebody's like, oh, I just can't wait to get around you. I want you so much. I just want to be next to you. How does that feel? It's a whole different energy, right? When he's feeling desired, when he's feeling your energy, and you're giving off all the vibes, and you're just like, yes, and I feel good, and I feel better when you're around, and it's this vibe and this flow, everything happens. But here's the problem. Here's the problem. We are so deep in our masculine, and we're so deep in our doing and our fixing and our hows, and we're not shifting into that feminine place. We're not letting ourselves get excited. And here's what I really want to say to you. And I had a client, and we were talking about it. And here's what a lot of us, where we stop ourselves. We don't want to experience the discomfort. We don't want to experience the disappointment if we weren't going to get what we want. We've been hurt because all of us are grown. We're grown women now. We've experienced what that feels like when you want something so bad and it doesn't happen. So because we felt that, we never want to feel that again. We never want to feel it again. It hurt. So we spend our lives avoiding it. We spend our lives keeping that just a little bit back, because we are so afraid to experience that discomfort, that disappointment. So we don't want to give it all away, because then if we give it all away and they hurt us, then what? Here's the problem with that. They feel this energy. How do you expect, and yes, we're talking a lot about love and relationships and all the things, I'm feeling very like that, but I promise you it all connects. How do you expect to experience this on such a deep level? How do you expect to get everything you possibly want and desire in this life if you're not really even willing to let yourself have it because you're afraid that if it goes, or maybe if it doesn't come in the way that you want, that would hurt. That would feel uncomfortable. That would feel really disappointing. And as women, we don't want to feel that way. So we spend our whole lives avoiding this. The problem with avoiding is you don't get what you really want while you're avoiding. And avoiding is an action. Avoiding is masculine. Let me explain something to you, ladies. You're built to receive. You're built to experience. You're built to feel. Why are you avoiding the very thing that you are built for? We're designed for this shit. You can handle this. Because here's the thing. When you think back to the greatest love affairs in your life, if you think back to the greatest moments of your life, there's always a little bit of hurt, a little bit of discomfort, a little bit of disappointment, but that's, ladies, that's what makes us know that we're living. This is all the fun. Why are you avoiding the fun? And I know some of you are like, well, hurt doesn't feel good, and that's not fun, but when you don't feel, when you don't hurt, you're dead. I don't know about you, but I want to feel alive. I want to feel completely alive. So here's this. Once you realize that you're okay. You're built for this hurt. You're built for these feelings. You're okay. You're safe in your feelings. Once you realize that you can experience and you're built for this, changes the game. Because then nothing can shake you. Nothing can rock you once you realize how powerful you really are. So then the disappointment doesn't become so scary anymore. Then it turns into, I don't really care what happens. I'm just gonna have the fucking time of my life while it's here. I'm just gonna enjoy this. I'm just gonna experience this. Experience is feminine. I'm just gonna feel whatever I feel because it's something. And numbing is nothing. Don't you wanna feel something? Don't you want to feel that feeling of when they walk in a room and you can't wait to get your hands on them? That you can't wait to get enough of them? That you can't wait till that even when they touch your shoulder, you get shivers inside? Are you just going to be like, no, I don't want to feel that. No, I don't want to feel that. I'm just going to play it safe. I'm just going to have lukewarm sex. I'm just going to have a lukewarm relationship because I'm scared. Yeah. So this is better. I'm just going to live my whole life and I'm just not going to experience any major mind blowing anything. And I'm just going to stay here and I'm just going to play this business safe. I'm just going to have this safe career and I'm just going to have this safe house in this little corner. And it's not going to be anything exceptional or magical. It's just, but I'm going to be safe. Yeah. Let me know how that works out for you. So here's where this ties in. Okay, this is where this gets good. Men are attracted to our feminine. We want cuddles, we want love, we want it. There's a little bit of masculine and feminine in all this, but I don't know about you, but most women I've ever talked to want a man to take her. You want a man to be strong and to hold you tightly and to hold you down and to just ravage you, to take you, to hold you tightly and squeeze you in and just really give you the best orgasms and time and sex and just have it be mind-blowing. Most of us don't want average. Do we really? Do you want average? Here's what it looks like when we're in our masculine and a man's in his feminine. And then he's coming in and he's like, okay. And you're going to come in and you're going to have sex and you're like, okay. And honey, it's okay. Let me brush my teeth first. I'm going to brush my teeth and then I'm going to, you know what I mean? I'm going to do these things and put these away. And then I'm going to, you just lay there. It's okay. And just get under the covers. Oh, and don't wear that, honey. That makes you look a little slutty. And then I'm going to come and I'm going to get under the covers and I'm going to do some missionary. And then we're gonna be done. And I had an orgasm. Wasn't that fun? Wasn't that great? Glad you had fun. Yeah, it was okay. Do you want that? Because we were so much in our masculine, he was just there to receive. He was just there for it. And he was just settling. No, be in your feminine. I'm so excited. I can't wait. The way you touch me, the way you, oh my God, I can't wait. I can't wait. Just the way you put your fingers on me and just, and you're talking to your man and then he comes home and he can't wait to get through the door and he's throwing things aside. You can't even make it to the bedroom. Things are falling down, statues, glasses, breaking, all of this. And then, child, I'll scream now. Yeah, we're really in our feelings right now. And then, everything, that it's like the earth stood still. You don't care who's around. You don't care who's, I mean, like, it's just like, and then it just happens and it's just like, and you don't have to do anything. He's got it. He's moving you all around and you're flipping upside down. You're on your head. You're in your, and you're just like, I don't even know what the fuck is happening right now, but I'm here for it. Oh my God. Yeah. Like, yeah, I'm here for this. And it's the best sex of your life and you feel connected and it's just, you feel like he reads your soul and you're there and you're surrendering and it almost is uncomfortable, but it feels good, and you're scared, but it feels good and you keep going. That's a different dynamic because you're letting him be a man and you're there to receive, you're built to receive. So let's keep going with this and how this pertains to everything else. So let's go ahead and do that with money. So back in the day when you used to date and you're dating, okay, and you're really excited about someone, think about in the beginning, if you're married, your husband, and like, oh, you get those texts, you're so excited, and yeah, that perfect dance. And then you're in the text and you're like, oh my God, I'm so excited. And I'm like, oh, I can't stop thinking about you and all these other things. And you're have all that building and you're in that beginning. He's excited when you're like, oh, he's like, I can't make it. And you're just like, oh, it's okay. I just miss you. I can't wait till the next time I see you. And you're able to just be feminine instead of, well, that's really disappointing that you can't make it. You really would like it if you showed up because you said you would. Or you're saying you're being feminine. You're saying you're letting it go. You're being really laid back. You know how we pretend to be laid back, but meanwhile, you're checking your texts every 5 minutes. Ladies, how you show up in one way is how you show up in the other way. When you're checking your texts 2 minutes, did he see it? Did he see that really cool thing I sent him? Does he love me? He doesn't love me. He didn't respond. It's been an hour. He left me on red. Oh my God. What does that mean? How he doesn't care. He doesn't love me. He doesn't even think about me. He just left me on open. Oh my gosh. It's been like an hour. Really? Like, people, come on. Listen, Linda. How you show up in one way is how you show up in another. If you wouldn't do it with your man, why would you do that in your business? Why would you do that with your manifestations? Why would you do that with your money? Think about your money. If you were excited that the money was coming, if you're so excited, you're turned on by the fact the money comes and you're like, oh my gosh, the money's coming. I'm so excited to see you. You've been away, but it's so good. I'm so glad you're here. You make me feel so good. You make me feel alive again. You see how this translates? You make me feel alive. You make me feel full of purpose, full of joy. Oh my God, you just make my world better. When you check your bank account 25,000 times, if you check if the payment is coming in, you're that girl. You're that girl who's checking her text every 5 minutes and complaining because he left you on red. and nagging him because he took 10 minutes to respond to your call or respond to your text. Does that make the man want to come to you? Does that make the people want to come to you? Does that make money want to come to you? Your need to be in control of the outcome is blocking you from your ability to receive. That's one to write down. Your need to control the outcome is blocking you from your ability to receive. I feel you. I've been here. I'm secretly a control freak. I've had my moments. But when you challenge, when you tell the universe how it's supposed to work, it's taking too long. I wanted it now. I don't want it next week. I want it now. I want it now. I want to know. I want to know that you love me. I want to know that you're here for me. I want to know. I want to know. I want to know. I want to know. And I want it to feel amazing. And I want it to feel joy. And I don't trust. I don't trust that you're going to come on your own because I don't trust how powerful and how magnetic I am. And I don't really know how awesome. And do you think I'm pretty? Do you think I'm fat? Do you think your universe wants to bring you what the hell you want? And then when you say the universe takes too long, I'm just curious, when did you become smarter than the universe? I'm just curious. So the key is most people need more pleasure. Most people don't know what turns them on. Most people don't know how to receive. You don't know how to receive pleasure. You don't know how to receive. You don't know how to get excited. You don't know how to work with that buildup and to get excited about that buildup. You don't know how to work with that kind of energy. Therefore, you block yourself from receiving all that you are meant to receive because of your need to control. So one of my favorite quotes I taught myself in my manifestation journey, and this is how this works, and just to give you some backstory on me, I've manifested more proposals than I can count. I've manifested cars, I've manifested houses, I've manifested apartments, I've manifested opportunities, I've manifested it all. But I only manifest when I give up my need to control. So how that looks is I desire what I want. I desire it. I never need it. I desire it. I desire what I want. I make it feel good. I make myself a place it wants to go. There's no nagging here. I'm not going to nag you. I'm not going to tell you what you should and shouldn't do. I'm just going to be here and be excited about when you come to see me. When you bring me my desires, I'm so excited and I'm so here for it because I trust that I'm so damn good at what I do and that I'm so good and I'm so magnetic that you want to be in my presence. Therefore, you come and you come over and over and over again. So I trust that the money is going to come. I trust that my desires are going to come. I trust that what I want is already done. Why do I trust it? Because I just do. Logic is masculine. If you're looking for logic, you are in your masculine. Try checking your energy. Logic is masculine. Your need for it to make sense is why it's not working. It doesn't make sense. It doesn't need to make sense. You just think it does. Just trust it. So here's the thing. Here's the thing. My manifestations never make sense. That's how I know I manifested it. They never. The universe doesn't. God and the universe don't have your rules. They don't have your limitations. They don't follow the rules of this world. Do you think God and the universe play by the same rules? Credit scores don't make a difference when you play in this game. When you play by these rules, it doesn't even fucking matter. Does it matter? Because God is not limited by your bank account or by your credit score. The universe isn't limited by that. You're limited by that. And when you're trying to find a solution, you can only find a solution that's so far because you're in your masculine and you're human. But manifestation is a spiritual game. It's not a human. It's not on the physical plane. It's on the spiritual plane. So it doesn't play by your rules. That's the thing to learn here. So with that being said, when I want something, I have to ask myself, do I really want it? How much do I want it? How does it make me feel? How would it make me feel if I wanted for somebody else to see them have it? How would we celebrate? What would it look like? What would it feel like? What would it taste like? What would it smell like? What's around me? What's going on? I can tell you, when I've manifested houses and things like that, I literally drive to the house at different times a day. I might go get a coffee, and then I'm not controlling myself to do it. I'm just like, huh, I'm just gonna drive over here. I just wanna see how I feel. Notice that feeling is feminine. I wanna see how I feel, so I'm gonna drive. Like, I'm driving down this neighborhood into my new house, and I'm gonna just drive slowly, and I'm watching the kids playing on the sidewalks, and I'm seeing the neighbors, and I'm waving, and I'm just like, oh my God, that's my new neighbor. We're gonna be like best friends. And then I'm just like driving around, and I'm just like, how do I feel? Then I park my car, and then I walk the neighborhood. I'm like, I would take walks like this. When I live here, I'm gonna take walks like this. Do I feel at home when I do that? Is this the house? Is this for me? Do I really want this? And then I keep doing that. Same with money. You feel into those feelings on a deep level. You don't worry about the how. You don't worry about the strategy. You don't worry how it's going to come to you. You just know that you want it, and that's enough, because that's how magnetics work. You're radiating this frequency, and it can't help but to come. If you ever put a magnet in a penny, the penny just floats to it. It's almost like it's flying. It can come from the countertop to the magnet. It just lifts up. It just lifts up. And it touches. That's how this is. That's how this works. You're so magnetic. It's just drawn to you. It doesn't need to make sense. You need it to make sense. But when you release that control, when you give up your need to know that, that's when everything happens for you. So just doing this, just going into playing in these energies and going and doing these things and having and visualizing what you want and feeling these feelings and decided that it's meant for you, and then saying, you know what? Ultimately, I release the control, and it's either this or something better. And I could release the control of what I want and what I think and make room for what's meant for me. Because you're limiting the universe when you just narrow it down to this one thing. What if the universe wants you to have all the things? What if it wants you to have all the things? And so playing in that energy, and I write it down and I journal, and if that feels good to you. But mostly I just am, and you're just being, and you're just in this space and of belief. Yes. And yes, Jenny says it's so simple, isn't it? For me, it's all about the unlearning. Absolutely. It's not meant to be difficult. You were just taught that it was. And so now I'm going to take you in a space where you're going to unlearn that whole paradigm. You're going to unlearn all of these things that were taught to you of what life should be, and relearn a whole new way that feels better, that creates more magic than you could ever imagine. So when you tap into this, when you appreciate, when you make it feel like it's a place it wants to go, then your manifestations will come to you when you know what to do with them. When you won't freak out when you get it, because you know it's meant for you. You've been feeling in those energies all along. You never had any doubt that it was coming to you because you knew it was meant for you. If it's meant for me, it's going to happen, because that's the way God works. That's the way the universe works. So it's done. It's done because I believe that it's done. Because I have faith. Faith is when it looks like something absolutely isn't going to happen, in those moments, in the moments that most people quit, in the moments when most people shut it down because they don't want to feel that disappointment, they don't want to feel that discomfort, that in those moments when it looks like your dreams are going to come true, it's the faith that they still are. It's that kind of faith. That's what faith really looks like. When it looks like all the odds and everything on the physical realm looks like it isn't going to happen, it's that pure faith of it not making sense, but knowing inside that it's still happening. It's happening, it's happening, it's still happening. And you smile when you learn this, because you have this overwhelming feeling of knowing. Because it's true, because you've witnessed it. And think about the times that it's happened in your life and we can go over this. I really think I'm going to end up doing another video. If you guys are enjoying this, let me know. Leave it in the comments, even if you're writing the replay. If you're watching, writing, what am I saying? If you're watching the replay, let me know. Does this resonate with you? Is this something that adds value to you? Are you learning something? If this is valuable, if this is learning, if you're getting it, if you're getting that, the fact that you can't go around texting and being needy and asking if it's gonna come and being insecure and begging it to stay, you have to trust, you have to be magnetic, you have to be a place that it wants to go. Exciting and magical. No, but this woman knows what to do with me. This woman knows. This woman is where I want to be. Yeah. It is happening. I love that. It's always happening. You're always manifesting it every moment of the day, every thought, every action. And here's the thing. We have negative vibes. We have moments. We have moments of self-doubt. We have moments of all of the negative things as well. And I'm not going to be the person to tell you that that never fucking happens. I'm human. Do I doubt myself? Hell yeah. I have moments. I have moments of everything. But I can tell you what I do in those moments is it's what I do in those moments that makes a huge difference. It's because ultimately I've gotten to a place where I know. I'm going to tell you something, and it's kind of personal, but I'm going to tell you anyway. I'm going to share this with you because we're friends now and I trust you. And this is the most profound thing in my life is to hit rock bottom so many times. To hit ultimately rock bottom, to experience what it's like when your worst fears come to light has been the biggest gift in my life. And you don't have to learn that way, by the way, but it's been the biggest gift in my life. And I'll share with you, I have videos for days. I think I'm gonna make 3 days of videos if you guys are here for that. But hitting rock bottom, feeling as if I had no one and I had nothing, and I felt like I was losing grips on everything I've ever owned and everything I had. And in those moments where I felt like everything went and I felt like I was faced with the truth on what would happen if this person didn't love me. What would happen if everybody abandoned me? And when I face my worst fears, it's been the greatest gift because I was speaking with my father and he says, this is why you're powerful. And I said, really, how so? This was a while ago. And he said, because you've already felt an experience. You already have gone to the depths of the ocean. You've already experienced what's the worst that could ever happen. You've already been there. So now you absolutely have nothing to fear. Because you've gone there and you've made it out. So now you really know that you're truly unstoppable. And I said, you're right. You're right. And you can do this with your mind. You don't have to do this the hard way. I'm just stubborn. So you don't have to do this the hard way. And you can make this simple by learning and taking yourself there and just saying, even if the worst that could ever happen, I'm gonna be okay. And learning your truth, like, hey, I always have this about myself. I'm smart, I'm this, I'm that. I'll always be okay. Finding that simple truth changes the game because then you have nothing to be afraid of. You have nothing to be afraid of. And that changes things. That keeps me out of that longer because I know it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what you do. It doesn't matter what this person does. It doesn't matter what that person does. That's all their stuff. And so embracing that feminine energy and using that in a way to manifest. And really, I'm going to give you guys some homework too in some of these videos if you guys want it. But I really want you guys to experience pleasure, especially women who have lived part of their life. They're not young women anymore. We're away from our teens. We're away from the beginning. And some women in your 20s, I don't know if early 20s, you might be experiencing this, but I really find this to be women who are heading into further levels in their life, what happens is we can remember a time when we're magnetic. We can remember the time when we walk in a bar and everyone's looking at us and all the men are staring and they can't get enough and the people are looking and the women are looking and everything. And you're just like, life is going for you. Things are happening in your life and things are good and you're just, and you're in that flow. But then we forget. We get so stuck in life and in the responsibilities and living in the doing that we forget that part of ourselves. And when we forget that part of ourselves, we forget that this could all be that simple and we already have that magnetism and we've watched it work. Half of you have probably manifested your relationship. It's just that once it stops producing those feelings for you, then you're done with it because you don't know how to recreate them for yourself. And the key of continuous happiness is being able to consistently recreate those feelings for yourself and not expect the other person to do it. Because it's all you. You're always creating it. It's never them. Like, I can create romance in any relationship. I can create that desire and that pleasure in any situation if I choose to. It's the thing is, if do you choose to? And I can create it with money, and I can create it with things, and I can create it with my manifestations, because I can create that feeling of excitement. Like, I was getting buzzy for this video and I'm like, ooh, I'm so excited. I can't wait. Is it 2:30? Is it 2:30? Is it 2:30? I want to be on. I can't wait. And I'm building that excitement all day. And that's like the tease. That's like women like the foreplay, right? Like, so I gave myself foreplay all day and I was super pumped up and super excited and raring to go when it happened. If you can apply the same principles to your life, into your manifestations, into your money manifestations, into your relationships, you will change your freaking world. You'll change your world. Watch how fast a man's disposition changes when you shift to this type of energy. Watch how fast. You're always in control. He's never got the power. You have the power. Just like you're in control of the money. It's just the money doesn't trust you and you don't trust it. So why should it come to you? The opportunities, you don't trust that they'll really come. You're like keeping it at arm's length, like it, because it might hurt you. When you surrender, you allow yourself to receive. And that's really what it's all about. Yes, you still got it, girl. I have that shit till I'm 70. You gotta embrace it. Like, we all can have it. Have you ever seen an older woman who's deep within her feminine freaking power? I'm just like, yes, get it. That's gonna be me. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. We can always tap into it. You can be 90 and be a fucking boss with it. You can be like, ugh, like she just got that something. She is so fiery. I love it. Yeah, rewatching again and again. I love it. Yeah, I'm thinking about making this a 3-part series of seducing the universe. And tomorrow or later, I don't know. So let's see what I'm feeling called to do. I think tomorrow might be good. I'll pop on, and what I'll do is I'll give you guys some activities to do because I wanted to educate you on what this was and all of the things about it. On these energy types and how we use it to attract and to do all of that. So, but I'm only going to do this if you guys want it. Cause like, I know this shit, I got it. So, but if you want this for your life, then I'll do it. Yes. You're just getting like fine wine. Jimmy, you are like hyping me up. This is going to be the best weekend. Aren't you know why it's like fine wine? Because you're learning your freaking power. You learn that you can do this shit on your own. Like, you can fill your own damn cup. And how powerful is it to know that you want someone else, that you desire them, and that you hold the power? That you don't need to know the outcome. It's just like you can create these feelings. Oh, it's so good. I can't wait. We're gonna talk about this tomorrow. I'm so excited. I have like so much more. Like, because there's ways that you can cultivate this for yourself. And honestly, it can help your, thank you. You can help your relationship. So here's the deal. I could teach you the strategy. I could teach you just manifestation. I can teach you just money. I can teach you it all. But I don't believe in it. So it's inauthentic. So I believe in overall abundance. I truly believe that women can have whatever the fuck they want. I believe you can have great sex, a man who can't get enough of you. I believe this in my soul because I've seen it. I've watched it happen. Like, if you want to get married, you can get married. We can get you engaged within a month. Men only need about 2 to 3 weeks to decide when you're in your feminine power. I'm being fucking honest. I've had it happen over and over again. My parents joke about it. And I just thought everybody knew this, but I'm learning that they don't. And I'm doing you guys a disservice by not sharing. And when I want to be single, it's because I choose to be. It's because I'm choosing it. Because I want to learn more about myself and become back even more powerful. And it's the same with money. It's the same with everything. It's all the same. It's all intertwined. I believe women can have great orgasms, have a man who can't get enough of them. I believe if you want that, I can believe, or a woman, who knows? I'm equal opportunities over here. I believe you can have a lover to rock your world in a relationship that sets your heart on fire. I don't care who it's with. And I believe that you can create as much money as you want at any moment of your life. And I believe you can have fun, and I can believe you have abundance. And I believe it doesn't have to be so fucking complicated. And I believe the fact that you believe that it has to be complicated is stemming from the fact that